Okay, great, thanks. So now we're going to go into the feedback from the working groups. Cyril, yeah. Who's up?
Right, and our lucky first contestant is media, actually. So we've got Lucia who wants to talk about media. If we can keep these to 1 minute and a half. If we can keep these to 1 minute and a half, that'll be fantastic. Can you raise the volume a tiny bit, please? Right, first person is Lucia from media.
Okay, great. I've got a lot to get through, so forgive me being very brief. Now, just as a quick media roundup for today, we had a little bit less press this today and broadcast media, but it does get quite busy around lunchtime. So we did have some people here, including Newsnight, which there's going to be a piece on Newsnight tonight, looking at here and the future and how we link up with other actions. So please keep an eye on that if you can. Get your friends to have a look. We've also got the Guardian flash mob here today with lots of different journalists, and we have a Guardian journalist staying with us in the occupation, so please make him welcome and engage and talk and share your experiences with your politics. Okay. We sent out a press release yesterday sharing the statement that we've agreed as an assembly. We didn't send out one today because we were trying to get ourselves sorted out. Now, we have sorted ourselves out. The tech team, the amazing logistics shelter, all the guys who have helped sort this out. We set up a tech team tent over there and also a press tent. And the reason why we've done that is because we need a visible presence so we can reflect what's happening here and get your stories. If anything has happened, any acts of kindness and generosity, please come and see us. If you want to train to be a media volunteer or get some support, please come and see us. If you have any inquiries about any form of media, please come and see us. We're there to help. One other thing, there's a lot of overlapping between all the groups and media, so please bear that in mind. A call out has gone out for people to make banners that would reflect the press statement, the statement that we've made together. If you know any creative banner makers, please get that going, and we'd love to be able to facilitate that as well. The other thing which is exciting news, which is tomorrow we're going to be linking up with Frankfurt Occupation and Wall Street Occupation in a live link. This is not a video link, this is a text conversation between the occupations about how you put on an occupation. And this is going to be shown, the full transcript of that conversation is going to be shown on the Guardian website. So we really hope this is going to encourage other occupations to start in this country and in other parts of the world. So we would like people from each working group to submit a few questions. Come and see us in the morning if you can. And if you as individuals have any questions, we'll try and incorporate that too. Come say hi to us in the tent. Thank you very much.
The next person we've got on is going to be Ronan from Church Liaison Group, and I'd also like to call out for any of the other working groups that would like to speak tonight, because for the moment it's just these two, so if you have anything to say, please come up to the front and I'll put you on. Thank you. Is that loud enough for everybody? Mic check?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Ronan.
Hi there. Yesterday a couple of us met with Canon Giles Fraser and had a very, very good talk with them. They are very pleased to defend our right to protest and support us in that. Obviously, you know, with having us as new neighbours, it puts extra difficulties on them, unexpected. So, you know, we very much want to work as much with them to make it as easy as possible. I wanted to ask whether we might be empowered to send a message of thanks and a pledge to keep the space as tidy and neat as possible so that we can live in harmony with them. Is that a yes? It looks like it to me. Thank you. Also, just some very quick notes. I mean, in terms of the steps, because St. Paul's is completely unfunded, it is not funded by the state, it is not funded by the Church of England, it is essential that people are able to, they make their money from tourists coming to visit. So we would ask that if the steps can be clear, so that it is very easy for the tourists to come in there, that would really help in our relationships with the church. We will probably also do up some nice signs just to kind of make that clear so that new people that arrive can see that at the same time. we are working with them in terms of noise to manage when we have assemblies and other events. So, you know, that's why assemblies are around here. We would ask that, you know, do check what time their services are, and they're all on the board over there, and just manage kind of when you put things on. And one last thing is, in terms of any questions, you know, should we ask the church this or that? Generally, they can facilitate us, but they cannot be, you know, helping us in terms of providing things like electricity or not. So if it's something that's stepping over the mark, probably the answer will be no. All right. Yeah, any inquiries, just come to the info desk, and then they have numbers for people in the church liaison group.
Thank you, Ronan. Can we have Venus up next, please, to talk about recycling and general waste, please?
Yeah. Yeah. Recycling! Yeah.
General waste. Okay, thank you to everyone who's been using the recycling correctly, and I encourage everyone who isn't to please notice which is plastic. You just read the signs. Take the time to read the signs. It makes our job so much easier. I met with the police and the council today. They gave me 3 recycling bins at the front. I've noticed still, even with all the signs, people are putting general waste in there. If we contaminate these bins, they will take them away, and it will make life really, 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 really difficult. So I ask you please to recycle very consciously. Paper cups are not recyclable. They have plastic on the inside, and it's unfortunate. And with that, I urge you to bring your own plates, your own cups, and your own cutlery, just to make it easier, so we don't have to keep consuming, because we're trying to reduce that, are we not? Yeah. Yes. There's more in there. It's not coming out. I'm very, very tired. Please use the recycling properly, and please use your own stuff. Reduce consumption. Constantly, recycling should be the last option. Thank you very much.
Not ideal, but the person who was supposed to speak, right, okay, we're going to have Hannah speaking for the info board and the info group.
Massive apologies that I'm facilitating and also representing the info group. It shouldn't happen like this, which is why we'd like to restate that we'd really like people to come to the process group meetings, so they can be involved in this process, so we can make sure we're hearing all sorts of voices. The info tent, we want it to be the portal for information. If you have any information about what's going on here, tell the info tent. If you want any information, tell the info tent. If you're in a working group, please, there's a lot of people coming and saying, where's this group? Can you come and inform the info group who your group is, what you're doing, so we can get other people to you. The info group needs volunteers really urgently, so if you can spare like an hour, half an hour, however long, to be trained up in the wonderful ways of the info tent, that would be much appreciated.
Just 2 very quick points. Can Phoenix come to the front and talk to us? And also something that got skipped out, basically people have been using bottles of urine,